They have been around for many centuries. They are foremost of the world's fashion industry and often associated with female style. They are called high heels. Welcome to Radical Thought. Today's radical question is, are high heels really bad for health? The history of high heel shoes dates back as far as the 10th century. The earliest preserved shoes are from 15th century Persia. It may come as a shock, but high heels were originally invented for men. And they weren't invented for fashion either. Rather, they were made for soldiers who wore them to help secure their feet in stirrups. Eventually, Persian migrants brought the shoe trend to Europe, where male aristocrats wore them to appear taller and more formidable. And that's when these shoes started becoming status symbols. During the reign of King Louis XIV of France, some 200 years later, wearing heels really began to take off among men. Chopines are pedestal-like shoes that changed the upper-class European woman into a towering figure. Chopines were often used as overshoes, quite famous in Venice, so that the women could avoid getting their shoes dirty. Chopines were completely hidden under the skirts, so the higher the footwear, the more cloth was required for the dress, hence another indication of status. Platform shoes predate heeled shoes, but because many women would fall over their platforms, the shoemakers realized that they needed to give women height while making the shoes safer. So they carved out the front of the platform and created a high heel which was biomechanically more sound than platforms. The first recorded instance of high heel shoes being worn by a woman was by Catherine de Medici in 16th century. She was about 150 centimeters tall, and it is said that she wanted to appear taller at her wedding. Up until that time, women had been wearing platform shoes, some as high as 60 centimeters in 16th century Europe. But after Medici died, that was the end of heeled shoes for women in terms of fashion. So women started to wear lower heels again. But men liked this idea of towering above everyone else, including Louis XIV, who also gave his name to an actual heel itself, called the Louis heel. In 1673, King Louis XIV introduced shoes with red heels and red shoes to the French court, which was his critical badge of honor. He restricted the wearing of such shoes to his circle of nobles. He would parade around with very tight-fitting high-heeled shoes. Wearing heels without permission would cost people their lives. The practice was later taken up by royalty across Europe and became highly fashionable. The color coding identifying superiority and privilege was quickly copied by aspirants. In the old days, there were fewer people wanting to be fashionable. But with the passage of time, that all changed, as human survival process was better taken care of. People were able to invest more in their desires, so accessories like heel shoes also developed, and out of all heels, stiletto category was the most difficult to construct, because the pencil-thin heel was unable to withstand the weight of the person. After World War II, people had the necessary technology and it was finally created. The secret of the stiletto heel was a small piece of metal called a shank, which joined the inside of the shoes sufficiently that the heel and the foot of the shoe could operate separately, as it could actually bend and twist. While the history of these shoes is all very interesting, the same can also be said about its effects on a person's health. Normal weight distribution of a person is around 60% on the heel joint and 40% on the ball joint. When a person wears heels, the balance is shifted more on the ball joints, which are primarily designed for support only, and this balance can vary depending on the height of the heel. A 2001 survey conducted by researchers from Pennsylvania State University using 200 women found that 58% of women complained of lower back pain when wearing heels, and 55% of women said that they felt the worst overall back pain when wearing the highest heel. The researchers explained that as heel height increases, the body is forced to take on an unnatural position to maintain its center of gravity. This changed position places more pressure and tension on the lower lumbar spine, which explains why the women complained of severe back pain at a higher heel length. Once a heel is worn, the body will attempt to compensate for the offset balance by flexing and forward bending the hips and spine. In order to maintain the balance, the back and calf muscles become tense, and after long periods, this makes for excess muscle fatigue and strain. The normal S-curve shape of the back acts as a shock absorber, reducing stress on the vertebra. Wearing high heels causes a lumbar spine flattening and posterior displacement of the head and thoracic spine. Daily high heel use for a number of years can actually lead to changes in your anatomy, as wearing them puts undue stress on your knees as well. Hence, calf muscle can shorten and tendons may thicken. Another effect of excess high heel use is spondylolisthesis, or the slippage of one's vertebrae from another. Foraminal stenosis is a spinal nerve condition that can occur when anatomical abilities block or reduce space in one's foramina. Having this condition in the lower back can cause symptoms of shooting pain. Last but certainly not the least, we have bunions. This is probably the most visible effect of prolonged wearing of high heels. Bunions is a deformation of the joint connecting the big toe and the foot. Bunions can lead to difficulties finding properly fitting footwear and may force a person to buy a larger size shoe to accommodate the width of the bunion. If the bunion deformity becomes severe enough, the foot can hurt in different places even without the constriction of shoes. It is then considered as being a mechanical function problem of the forefoot. So what do you think? Are high heels really bad for health? How often do you wear them? Leave a comment. If you like this video, please like and share. If you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing so every new video reaches you immediately. So, with a new and exciting radical question, see you in the next episode.